Hello, this is Dr. Sachin Ahuja. Presently, I am working as Director Research at Kara University, Punjab. I am having 15 years of teaching experience. I have done B.Tech, M.Tech and Ph.D. in Computer Science and Engineering. My specialization is databases, data mining, machine learning and artificial intelligence. Today, we will be discussing about the topic normalization of databases. So as we all know, while studying databases, the most difficult topic for a student is normalization. Generally, we do not understand normalization because what we think normalization is not a technique to normalize, not only a technique to normalize databases, but also it is a technique that is generally employed to reduce the anomalies which are present in databases. So when we talk about normalization, in simple words, we could say that normalization is a database design technique which organizes table in a manner that reduces redundancy and dependency of data. So what we do in normalization, we generally improve the database design by generating more tables out of a single table, and each table hence generated is in a upper normal form. The main objective which we keep in mind during normalization is to create the relation where every dependency is on the key, the whole key, and nothing but the key. So why normalization is required? See, when we make databases, databases are generally divided into tables, which are also known as relations. And these relations contain data of a particular person or object, and this data is interlinked. Now, when we make a database, the database will be of an organization. That organization will have its employees, students or something which are related to each other, and we are storing these related data into database. Now if we talk about a university scenario, we want to make a database of university. So the main object here would be student, say example. So now student have various aspects in which we can store data. One can be a table where we can store personal information of a student, which can be retrieved when we want to know the father name, mother name, or any other number of a student in case of emergencies. Second can be the data related to a student when we want to retrieve academic data. Third can be the data related to a student when we want to store data related to his finances. For example, the data is stored by accounts department to see that how students are paying their fees. Other can be a data related to if the student is a hostler. So here you can see that in a same database, there are different relations of a single object, where different data of a single object is stored in different aspects. A student academic record, a student finance record, a student's personal record. Now, in such type of databases, generally there occur various anomalies. So these anomalies can be classified as insert anomaly, update anomaly, and delete anomaly. So when we talk about insert anomaly, when we insert a data about an object, it should be inserted at a single place in database. But as I have already told you in example of university database, we have to insert data of a particular student. So we have to insert it at multiple places, in his personal database also, in academics database also, in financial database also. So these types of anomaly generally occur when we insert data at one relation, but it does not reflect in other relations because database is not normalized. Same is with update anomaly. In update anomaly, what we do is we want to update a record related to a particular object in a tuple. We update in a particular relation, but that is not reflected in other tables or relations of that database. So when we retrieve the data from one table, a different data will occur, and from another table a different data will occur. Similarly, we can say of delete anomaly. In delete anomaly, since the data related to a particular student is present in multiple databases, multiple data sets, so what will happen, you have to delete it from multiple locations at a time. If you want to delete the data of that particular student, you have to delete it from its academic record, you have to delete it from its finance record, you have to delete it from hostel record, and you have to delete it from personal files also. So this is the scenario where these anomalies should be reduced to make a good database, and these anomalies are reduced using normalization. So there is a sequence of normal form. It is in 1NF, that is first normal form, which is considered as weakest. Then there is 2NF, 3NF, BCNF. So as we increase the number, the normal forms increase. The normal forms can be up to 6NF nowadays. But when it was first proposed by Dr. E.F. Codd, the normal form was proposed to be up to 5NF. Also, Dr. Codd said, keep the BCNF normal form is good enough for a database, and 4NF and 5NF are more of theoretical in use rather than practical, because practically they are very difficult to achieve. So as we can see in this particular slide, any normal form which is of higher value states that you have to achieve the previous value of normal form, then only you can achieve the higher value. That means if you want to achieve 2NF, the data should be first in 1NF. Similarly, about 3NF, data should first be in 2NF. And same is in the case with BCNF. If the database is in BCNF, then it should be first in 3NF. Now, to understand the normalization, first we have to understand what is functional dependencies. I would explain them in a very quick examples. So functional dependency of one attribute is such that if you want to determine an attribute, you must previously determine another attribute which explains the first attribute. For example, if we say A determines B, that means to know B, you should be able to know A, or A is explaining B. So here in this example, we have given that employee number determines email address. Also, we can say, for example, if you want to determine age and there is an other attribute, date of birth. So date of birth can directly determine age. So if A determines B, we can say that B is functionally dependent on A. In this table, as you can see, employee numbers are unique. By these unique numbers, you can easily determine email ID, father's name, and last name of the employees. So we can easily write functional dependencies such as employee number determines email, employee number determines father name, employee number determines last name. Also, what we can write is, we can directly write that employee number can determine email, father name, and last name. The attribute on left hand side is known as determinant. So we can also say that employee number is determinant of email. Now, we should know about transitive dependency. If A determines B and B determines C, then A can also determine C. This is known as transitive dependency. And we say that C is transitively dependent on A through B. This is an example of transitive dependency, where employee number determines department name and department number determines department name. So transitive dependency is employee number is determining department number, department number is determining department name. So we can say ki department name is transitively dependent on employee number through department number. Also, there exists partial dependency, where more than one attribute determines other attribute. Now we come to first normal form. See, when you are making a database, you would be inserting the values, you would be determining the attributes randomly. After that, you would be normalizing the database. So for normalizing, we have to start from 1NF. Now 1NF says ki if you are storing the values in a relation, all the values should be single valued and atomic. For example, in this case, you can see that employee number are unique, employee phone numbers are unique, but there are multiple degrees of same employee. So here what we can see, in employee degrees there are multiple values. So this table is not in first normal form. To bring it in first normal form, we have to reduce the attributes to single values. So in 1NF, what we do is we divided the relation having employee number, employee phone and employee degrees into two relations, one as employee and other as employee degree. Now employee number can determine employee phone in employee table, and in employee degree table the same employee number will determine one single degree of employee. So there you can see that we have achieved first normal form by breaking the table into two different tables, and both the tables have atomic values in every tuple. So to state that 1NF, we can simply see that following rules should apply on a table. First is, each table cell should contain a single value and each record needs to be unique. Now we talk about second normal form. As I have already told ki if you want to make a higher normal form, the table should be already in a previous normal form. So when defining 2NF or second normal form, we will say a table is in 2NF if it is in 1NF and every non-key attribute is fully dependent on each candidate key. That means we do not have any partial functional dependency. Now, what we have to see in this table is, see, here when we are defining a key, not every other attribute can be defined or determined by a single attribute. So to determine product number, you have to know invoice number and line number. No single attribute is able to determine every other attribute of the table. So this table lacks a key which is of single column. So to make it into one column, what we have done is we have broken the table into two different tables. Now first table will contain invoice number, line number, and second table will contain invoice number and invoice date. So now what you can see is, in second normal form, the table has to be broken into two different tables, In first table, the candidate key will be invoice number, line number, and in second, it would be invoice number. Now we come on 3NF. Now to bring a relation into 3NF, we have to make it into 2NF first. After that, we will determine the functional dependencies in that table. And the 3NF states that a table is in 3NF if it has a functional dependency where X determines Y, where Y is a non-key attribute, X is a candidate key, and a relation in 3NF should not have any transitive dependencies of a non-key attribute on a candidate key through another non-key attribute. Now again we talk about this table where we have four different attributes. We have employee number, employee name, department name, and department number. Now here we can see that employee number, department name are non-key attributes. Whereas department number determines department name, which is a non-key attribute, but department number itself is not a candidate key. Since it is not a candidate key and it is determining another attribute, this table is not in 3NF. So we have to divide the table, and to bring it into 3NF, we have to divide table into two. Both the tables should have a single key which determines all other attributes. So this table is divided into two different tables. One table has employee number, employee name, and department number. Here employee number is a key which determines both other attributes, employee name and department number. And department number and department name are in another table where department number can determine department name. So now breaking this into two tables makes it into third normal form. And last is BCNF, where BCNF is defined very simply. A relation is in BCNF if it is in 3NF and if every determinant is a candidate key. BCNF or Boy Scout normal form is used in online transaction processing systems. Usually we can meet this objective. However, we might denormalize 3NF, 2NF and 1NF. So now summarizing my lecture, normalization is generally done to avoid anomalies. Anomalies are of three types: update, insert and delete. To avoid these anomalies, database is normalized. Normalization are further categorized into 1NF, 2NF, 3NF, BCNF. There are also 4NF, 5NF and nowadays 6NF. 4 and 5 are of no practical use, so we will talk about only 1, 2, 3 and BCNF. 1NF says that all the values should be atomic. 2NF says ki there should be no full functional dependencies, partial dependencies, every dependency should be fully functional dependent. 3NF says there should be no transitive dependencies, and BCNF states that every determinant is a candidate key. I hope my lecture would make you understand normalization better. Thank you.